Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Iron Kaiser Gaming. This is Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds, the Expanding Fronts mod. And in today's video, I'm showcasing an epic 2v2 battle featuring some teammates that, at least from a lore perspective, you would not expect to see working together. So buckle in, because this is going to be a fun one. Now, before I dive into the match itself today, let me just say that I am really enjoying making these Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds videos. And I really hope that you are enjoying watching them. And if you are, I would love to hear from you guys. So let me just ask you right at the start to please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel if you haven't already. I really appreciate you guys to do that. And leave me a comment. Let me know in the comments below that you're enjoying the videos, and let me know what you want to see next from Iron Kaiser Gaming, and what you want to see from Star Wars or Age of Empires or Age of Mythology or whatever else. I want to hear from you guys, so leave me a comment. I really appreciate you guys to do that. Now, with that out of the way, let's go ahead and actually dive into today's match. We have, first of all, in the yellow, John the Late, playing as the big bad of the Star Wars universe, the Galactic Empire. And his ally to the north here, in the gray, we have Lucky Ashman playing as the Gungans. Now, if those seem like strange bedfellows, wait until you take a look at their opponents. Because in the south, we have a mashup of prequel and sequel trilogy. In the green, we have Attack or Die, playing as the bad guys of the sequel universe, the First Order. And their allies to the west, in the teal or the cyan, we have Jort, playing as the Confederacy. So, this should be a really interesting matchup. Dubak's coming in here, alright. Now, taking a look at the map, I'm really curious to see how this battle will play out, because if you, like, ignore the fighting, ignore the Dubak right here for a second, just take a look at the minimap. And what you will notice is that one team has a far more defensible position than the other. I think Lucky Ashman and his ally might have gotten lucky with the map generation. Take a look. Let's look at the Empire's point of view. We have a base almost entirely surrounded by trees. There is only a single entry point right here. Right? Here we go. Luring in a Dubak. Alright, good. Yeah, we're getting a lot of boar meat. Oh no. Why have you stopped running? Hunter. H-U-N-T-E-R, run! Is he gonna make it? No! He goes down! Oh no. Alright, that might balance out the defensiveness of this position, because he's got one entry point. And as long as this is secured, I mean, unless a path is cut through the trees, which can happen. But at least early on, H2 aggression, as long as he blocks this off, he should be safe. Ashman, likewise, I can already tell from the minimap, he's got this plan in mind. Yeah. Prefab shelter's going up. And has he actually built them already? Yeah. He's already kind of... Oh my goodness, there's a hole right there. I wonder if he'll see that. But once again, there is this barrier. You block this off, and if I'm not mistaken, I don't think there's a hole through here. So, yeah, and there's no hole there either. So, yeah. These guys in the north, they have a very defensible position. This is arena-esque for the Empire and the Gungans. Flame Trooper already out and running. If I'm remembering correctly, the Flame Trooper is a replacement for the Mounted Troopers. Let's see if I can... Yeah, look at him just chew through that light wall. You're going to need a response to that. The response appears to be lots and lots of housing.
Run!
Alright, so... First blood of the game, if you want to call it that, goes to the First Order, taking down a light wall. Unless you want to give first blood to the Dubak that took out that hunter. Poor guy. Either way, the Empire is kind of suffering the early aggression here. but the Confederacy will be jumping in to help the Flame Trooper. So yeah, we might potentially see some early aggression, early issues here. Now, John the Late, we're looking at his point of view. He's on the way up to tech level 2 right now. These guys must already be in tech level 2, if I'm not mistaken, in order to get out those troopers. If this house goes down, what are you gonna do, man? Are you gonna repair the house? Are you gonna build behind it? Just gonna keep building houses, huh? Alright. How about Lucky Ash, man? I gotta check. We will pause the game ever so briefly to take a look at these civilizations and what they're bringing to the table. But right now, I kind of want to watch the early pressure that is coming in from... I don't know what we want to call them. We'll call them Team Bad Guys. I mean, the Galactic Empire, they're obviously the villains of Star Wars, but... You know, you have the Gungans with you, so you can't be all bad, right? Some Star Wars fans might say that, thanks to Jar Jar, you know, actually the Gungans are the true villains of Star Wars. They're far worse than anything the Confederacy could throw at you. Interesting. Throwing a spaceport down right in the choke point. Obviously a big building. Hard to take down. I wonder if it's going to be difficult for the Empire to maybe get out of this choke point. We'll see. Either way, right now in Gungan territory, looks like it's just a mech factory coming online. A spaceport as well, so probably going up to tech level 3 quickly, I would imagine. He almost has the food and the Nova he's going to need to go up to tech level 3. I see, you know, there's no real aggression or pressure on Team Bad Guy. Team Gungan Empire, though. Now we're seeing the Gungans getting pressed by First Order troopers. I'm really curious to see... Normally, when you put aggression into H2... And I do notice the Gungan player recognized that whole plugin. Good for him. Normally, the typical thinking is, if you are playing in tech level 2, trying to get out early aggression, and you can't find any real damage, then that's a win for the defending player. We do see John the Late hit tech level 3. I believe he's first. Let me double check that. Attack or die, yep, in tech level 2. He's not close. Jort on the way up to tech level 3. So we might have a tech advantage for Team Gungan Empire. For at least a little bit. I was going to say, normally the thought process is, you know, if you're not able to find damage, the defending player really has a win on their hands. As long as they keep their eco going, you know, they stick to the game plan, they don't get flustered. Hey, how did that scout get in here? Has he been in here this whole time? I mean, I don't see a hole in the wall, so I'd assume so. That's going to be big. They can tell what's coming. So these TIE fighters will not be a surprise to Team Confederate Order. We'll call them that, maybe. Team Confederate Order will know that the TIE fighters are coming. Boom! That Flame Trooper goes down. Are we going to see air power from the Galactic Empire? This is going to be cool. Yeah, this scout does not have long to live. Meanwhile, this prefab shelter is about to go down. The Gungans need to be careful. A light turret coming online, protecting that Nova generation, which is a big deal. Light turret. Interesting choice. I wonder why you're not... like, reinforcing the wall and building the towers there. Let's switch over to... Not John the Late, I'm sorry. Attack or Die's point of view. He is on the offensive, still in tech level 2. Notice he also has anti-air troopers up, so if the TIE fighters try to come in and support the... as Gungan ally, they will get blown up. Unless he throws away those anti-troopers. Still one. There is still one. Interesting that the fighters are kind of staying on the defensive, not trying to raid. I'm a little surprised. I would have imagined, if I were John the Late, I would have sent the TIE fighters right into the Confederate base, and therefore, I would have lost them right away, because we have heavy anti-air troopers already up and running. Anti-air turrets are good. He knows. Air power is the concern. And he's going anti-air. Now these mounted troopers, though, yeah, they're not. They have no anti-air protection. Notice, one thing I forgot to mention about the map, by the way. Not a lot in the way of food resources. We do see a lot of carbon, which can, of course, translate into a lot of farms. That's how we get food in this match. But notice also all of the holocrons, which are like AoE2's relics. These are going to be a constant source of gold generation or Nova generation. All the holocrons are in the center of the map. So I'm really curious to see the players jump on those holocrons. I think that might be particularly important for Team Gungan Empire, because like I mentioned earlier, their trade route options are riskier than what the Confederate Order has available to them. So it'll be interesting to see whether they go for the holocrons or not. And speaking of, the First Order is about to hit tech level 3. Fighters coming out for the Gungans. So, both players in the north going for air. I have to wonder, and I'm speaking as somebody who, again, is a novice in the world of, you know, galactic battlegrounds. But I have to wonder if that's wise for both players to be prioritizing air power like this. It seems like it would be very easily counterable. Here we go. John the Late, is he going... Does he see it? Does he see it? Wait a minute. John the Late, we've got to check this out. Does he actually see... He doesn't see it. It's like just pure instinct that is keeping him from getting blown up. Wait, here we go. You're going to lose one. You're going to lose two. Three, I think? If I'm not miscounting, that was three TIE fighters that just went down there to a hail of Confederate anti-air rockets. And again, spaceport's on the front line. I'm just noticing that too. Let's turn off the fog of war here. Spaceport there. Do we see a spaceport up here? Yes, we do. Apparently, everyone just builds their spaceports right in the choke point. Ooh, and we see the Confederates. They are the first to try to take holocrons. He will get into the base. Now, he might go down before he can actually get it in, but being inside the walls means it will be a trivial thing. Nope. No, that apprentice does not go down. Unbelievable. I think at this point in the battle, and meanwhile... Okay, we're seeing our Sith player, our Empire player, also going for the holocrons, and if I'm not mistaken, getting more of the holocrons, because I see two apprentices out. A lot of farms to the Gungans. Ooh, air transport. Are you're gonna like transport in infantry and just drop them off behind enemy lines? That could be very cool. Oh, and here we go. The air transport dropping off a handful of strike mechs into the heart of the First Order base. What kind of damage are you going to find with four strike mechs? There's a mech destroyer already on the prowl. I don't know. I mean, if nothing else, this is important intel. I think this is good for the Gungan Empire to know, like, What kind of things are we seeing? First Order is slow to respond to this. If he's not careful, he's gonna lose units. Alright, he's responding now with some flame troopers. I would love to see this strike mech turn around and just shoot down that flame trooper, but that's not gonna happen. Alright. That was a fun little diversion. I don't think it gave them a lot, but it gave them intel. Builders moving forward, supported by fighters. We're building a fortress awfully close to the First Order base. And this is gutsy, because if you're looking at the scoreboard, Lucky Ashman is kind of trailing behind. Jor in the lead here with about 3,800 points. Well, 37 and some change. Attack or Die and John the Late are neck and neck in the 3,400 points. And then Lucky Ashman is about to crest 3,000. But the scoreboard can be very deceiving. And remember earlier when I said that I think the Holocrons would really benefit Team Gungan Empire in particular? Well, I don't know if they could hear me or not, but the Empire has collected its fourth Holocron. It's a really nice pickup there. Now, at this point, all of the Holocrons have been claimed. If I'm not mistaken, the Confederacy has one Holocron somewhere around here. No, where's your Holocron? Okay, we saw that Sith apprentice escape with a Holocron. I refuse to believe the Confederacy does not have Holocrons, but I'm not seeing it. It's not in the Sith Temple. Second Command Center coming online there. We should probably take a look at the economies in a second. Just get a sense of where everybody is. But I am really curious about this Fort Shield Generator combo. Definitely planning on holding that position for a while. Let me see, do you have a... Did it actually come over here, maybe? I didn't even see a Sith Temple for the First Order. Notice the heavy... Notice how everybody's going into anti-air troops. I think that if either one of these players, and the Gungans and the Empire both have good troopers, if you go into infantry, you might catch these guys by surprise. Here's a mech factory coming online for the Confederacy. Surely that's not your first. No, there's a second. Yeah, I would expect a lot of mechs coming in for the Confederates. Now, I'm not able to get vill counts in the blink of an eye, but I think it would be fun to take a second. Look at this fort plugging away at the shield generator. Looks like it's gaining more than it's losing. Jet troopers! Oh boy. These are, if I'm not mistaken, they're infantry. And I think they're treated like troopers, if I remember correctly. But the main thing, of course, is they're flying around, and so they can ignore a lot of the obstacles that would impede your regular trooper. Watch these things go. If I'm not mistaken, they also have an anti-building element to them, so you definitely want to deal with those guys fast.
Ready for battle.
Interceptors, which, judging from the name, if I remember correctly, interceptors, they are anti-air, right? Would be very good against the jet troopers. Oh, here they go. They're hiding in the trees. Oh no, Lucky Ashman, you are losing bills. I don't think he even notices. He notices now. Well, now it's Attack or Die's turn to notice that he's gonna lose his guys in this command center. Fast fighter. Nice.
Order
Interceptor, sir.
I might have it backwards. The Interceptor might actually be... I've got to check this. The Interceptor then is... Yeah, it's effective against other aircraft. That's what I thought. So the fighter... Well, what's the difference between the Interceptor and the Fast Fighter, then? Somebody in the comments will let me know. What's the difference between the Fast Fighter and the Interceptor? Because they both appear to be anti-air infantry units. I'm going to guess that one of them is better as a jack-of-all-trades all-arounder. And the other one is more specialized against air. Either way... I'm not concerned about the air right now. I'm concerned about the ground as we have mech destroyers moving in to take on the Galactic Empire. This is a really close match, by the way. If you're looking at the team score, it's neck and neck. It's about 6,300 to 5,900. That's not far at all at this point in the game. I would say that momentum is probably with Team Confederate Order, but not by much. Okay, really quickly, let's take a look at the pop. John the Late is just shy of 150 population. Tacker Die is at 98. Jort, also at 150. And Lucky Ashman is at 88. At about the 40-minute mark. We say 40 minutes. It's not actually 40 minutes. You can obviously tell from the replay, but in Age of Empires 2, the clock does go fast, even when it's set to normal. Both players in tech level 4. These are trebs, essentially. Cannons firing away at each other. What do we have here? I don't think this is a unique unit. This is infantry, right? Now, on the one hand, this fortress... Yeah, these are regular troopers. This fortress was protected by a shield generator, which is really nice. On the flip side... You know, you only have one cannon firing away versus two. That's gonna make a difference. This mech destroyer... Just from the... Thanks to the shield generator, I don't think it's gonna do a lot of damage. The strike mechs, though, those are anti-infantry mechs. Even with the shield generator. I don't know. I don't think that's a good fight. I know you don't want to lose your cannon, but I think you've got to back up. I think this position is lost. Interesting to see Jort slowly creep up on the Empire. He's not trying to overextend. Heavy mech destroyers. On the way to support Ashman? His Gungan ally? Power core going down. And with the power core going down, these troop centers are going to be... It looks like they're abandoned, maybe? I see nothing being produced from them, but... Even if they were, without a power core, they produce very slowly. Strike mech versus strike mech. Unfortunately, 1 versus 10. Not much of a fight. Undeployed cannons. Here comes the Empire. And if I were Jort, I would be thinking now is the time to attack. While the Empire is away, the Confederacy will play... And sure enough, that is what he's thinking. There's a lot of vulnerability here. Having said that, this was the perfect counter to what the First Order had in mind. All of these heavy... All of the units, man, that Attacker Die had, they're going down. Unfortunately for the Empire, the... Home defense appears to be mostly air. And the Confederacy's ready for it. Heavy anti-air troopers are pummeling these fast fighters. The attackers, they are anti-infantry, like anti-ground air units. I'm surprised we're not seeing more attackers. But I guess it's important to claim the airspace first before trying to utilize it. Magna Guard's up and running. If I'm not mistaken, they are kind of like the Teutonic Knights of Galactic Battlegrounds. Unfortunately, they're also dead. Because we just have a lot of heavy mech destroyers. And I think the Magna Guards, I think they count as mechs, if I'm not mistaken. So I think that was a good fight for the Confederacy, but also a fight where he's feeling the need to back up. I don't think he can push his advantage very easily here. Alright, I think while things have stalled out here, jump back over and see what's going on. Interesting that the Empire is keeping the heavy mechs. Those are some funny looking guys, especially that just slow it down a little bit here. Now, even at regular speed, these are some weird looking units. But I suppose it gets the job done. Just the walk cycle is very funny. But they are guarding the Gungan ally. It might have been a little bit of an overextension by Lucky Ashman, trying to build that fort up against Attacker Die's base. I think that you may need to pull back these mechs. I think you need them to deal with these mech destroyers. This fortress is going to go down soon. Attackers. Once again, though, you have the threat of the anti-air. I like the use of Dark Troopers. That's a good thing here. With heavy mech destroyers of his own. So now we got mech destroyers versus mech destroyers. Attackers are coming in. Anti-air troops. It's so hard to use air efficiently because it doesn't take a lot for your whole air force to get blown up. Strike mechs aren't long control. Notice how these anti-air units are able to use the shield generator too. Makes them that much more resilient. John the Late has to know he's losing air. I think he's calculating it's worth it. Throw them into the grinder, push this location. Because even as the air is gone, it does look like the Empire has taken the initiative from a ground point of view. And I don't think these flame troopers are gonna be that effective against heavy mech destroyers. I might be wrong about that, but this is a slog right here. This is just pure numbers. Yep, both. Whoa. AT-ST. AT-ST. The shield generator is not long for this world. Behold the little strike mech that could. Fort down. Not fort. Shield generator down. Anti-air turret. Probably not going to last that long either. We're seeing this push into Dark Troopers. So, one more time, very quickly, just check the tech tree so we know what we're dealing with. It is a range combat unit, a mechanized trooper that is stronger than the strike mech and an effective detector of stealth units. So, it looks like it's an anti-infantry unit. Strike mech adjacent. So maybe not super useful against what the Confederacy is currently deploying. But as we see the First Order going more and more into flame troopers, I think this is a really good choice here. Pushes on both sides of the lake. I find it so funny how there's very little action actually through the lake itself. Now that the holocrons have been collected, no one wants to fight down the middle. This has kind of devolved almost into two 1v1s. ATST's putting in work. You know, off the top of my head, as I'm casting this, this is an ATST, that's an AT-AT. Right? I have this paranoia, even as I'm casting this, that I'm getting it backwards. And that'll be so embarrassing. Someone's like, no! The chicken walkers are the AT-AT. No, I'm positive. The heavy assault mechs, those are the ATSTs. The little guys are the AT-ATs. Right? That's gotta be right. I'm wondering, you know, it seems like Lucky Ashman has a really good economy going. But he does seem to be behind, and I'm wondering why. I mean, obviously he suffered some early losses there in the center. Is he running low on Nova, maybe? Let's actually check. Yeah, so we're looking at his point of view. Running very low on resources, especially Nova. Meanwhile, we switch over to John Delay's point of view. Yeah, he's got resources in the bank. Those holocrons definitely helping out. I am surprised that we're not seeing more trade from, I guess, well, I was going to say both players, but no, here we go. Look at that trade. Yeah. Oh, wait a minute. I don't think this. I have, you might, if you look around in this game, you download it for yourself and try it out, you may find yours truly voicing a character or two. And I was checking to see if that was one of mine. I don't think it is, but I have to go back and check. The units, of course, are so heavily processed sometimes that it's not always easy to tell. This fortress getting blown up by the heavy assault mech. This is, this should be concerning. The team score is closing. Right now, the Confederate Order still has a small lead. Hummel's coming in. No, I'm sorry. Those are undeployed cannons. The Trebs. It makes me wonder, does Attacker die? Does he even have... Yeah, he's actually losing pop space here. Just check and see if there are any vulnerabilities. Cargo freighters for the Confederacy. Yeah, so both players are trading. Or at least, I'd say both teams are trading. I wasn't seeing a lot in the way of either First Order cargo or Gungan cargo. I we see AT-STs going down. Overextending maybe, not realizing. You're gonna lose all of these undeployed cannons. Oh, that stings. That's a lot of resources down the drain. The Dark Troopers should be a good choice against Magna Guards. Here we go, more heavy mech destroyers. More Dark Troopers. Yeah, this is definitely the tactic you want to take. Ah, here we go. Cargo starting up for the Gungans. Do we see... I see Confederate freighters. I'm not seeing First Order freighters. And that has me concerned for Attack or Die here. Very low on Nova. Meanwhile, let's get back over to the fighting here. Ah, this fort is getting sieged down. You needed these heavy mech destroyers. That's a good pick. I wish you had some Famba shield generators just to kind of even out the shield. The heavy mechs of your enemy are getting bonuses from the shield generator that you're missing out on in order to press this advantage here. So the good news is the cannon goes down, so this fort will stay standing another day. The Empire shows up with an undeployed cannon. Meanwhile, more fighting over here. Oh my goodness. AT-STs, AT-ATs. No, AT-STs, AT-ATs. Dark Troopers. Isn't the assault mech an up? No. I was gonna say an upgraded strike mech, but I think that's its own thing. Again, yeah, just like their version of the AT-ST. Yeah. It's a really good all around mech, if I'm not mistaken. The Confederate Order still has the score. It's within 1,000 points. No, I can't do math. It's 1,400 points. But even so, it's very, very close. This undeployed cannon, a little bit of a misclick there. It's so good for the Gungan player to be going into the heavy mech destroyers. Good call. I wonder if we're gonna see either player try to carve out a path through the trees and raid. That would be fascinating. Just checking resources really quick. I'm curious about the Nova. Attack or Die has next to nothing. Jort, next to nothing. Lucky Ashman, next to nothing. John the Late, 1500. He has far and away the best trade route. Yeah, just mech with all techs, and where is your trade? He's asking his ally. Exactly, both players are needing trade. John's got it, and I would say that Jort has it too. But I'm not seeing it from Attack or Die, and I'm not seeing it from Lucky Ashman. Looks like 250 is the pop limit. Interesting that Attack or Die is stuck at 220 right now. I'm not sure that he realizes he's down. Huge fight here. I'm really concerned. The Gungans we saw crush the Rebel Alliance in my last Galactic Battlegrounds video, but I'm afraid that they are slowly losing this fight to the First Order. I think that is me. I think the Mech Destroyer might be my voice. If I'm not mistaken. Because I remember I'd written a couple of lines and I had voiced some lines. And I think that was one of them. Anyway, just a random factoid. Let's see. Right, it feels right now like who's gonna fall first. Because on the northern battle, I think the First Order is doing a good job pressing their advantage against the Gungans. The Empire's needing to come over here to assist, which is drawing critical attention away from the southern fight. But the Empire seems to be doing a very good job taking on the Confederacy. Which is funny, because the Confederacy, I guess of the two players, the Confederacy actually has the higher score than the First Order does, but he's stuck on defense. I think this fort, fortunately, has an awful lot of shield generator behind it. You see the HP's kind of low. There's a lot of shield power there. If it goes down, that is very, very bad news. Gungans. Fortunately, it looks like it's the cannons that go down instead. Heavy assault mechs. The Empire coming in clutch alongside those Gungan heavy mech destroyers to repel this attack. And Team Gungan Empire has just taken the score lead. Good for them. Swim! Swim! You can do it! One thing that's huge here is this attack on the Confederate trade routes is huge. It, you know, if you can disrupt this, shut this down, you win the game, right? And so far, I mean, there's so much trade flying back and forth, so it's not Magna Guards. So it's not as if, you know, they've done that yet. But even just chipping away here and there, taking out trade routes, trade units. Especially if Jort doesn't recognize him. Look at him. Got four spaceports. Oh my goodness. That's a lot of spaceports. Warning, your armies are being attacked by attack or die. That's definitely not right. Whoa, here come heavy mech destroyers. They're seen and they're caught by these attackers. The attacker's not doing a whole lot of damage. Oh, and the anti-air getting a kill. You are going to need some anti-air or anti-mech support. This is huge. This fight right here, if this is successful, this will maybe define the game. With these mech factories going down. And you see, Lucky Ashman is really coming back into this, almost parallel to Attack or Die. So I think the Empire has bought the breathing room that the Gungans needed to really come back into this. ATST goes down fast in the face of the Magna Guards. I had said earlier they were Teutonic Knight-esque, but I might be mistaken. They actually might be closer to Samurai. Are they like anti... I forget if they're anti-Jedi or anti-unique unit, but they are extremely effective, as you just saw. The Dark Troopers doing a great job dealing with the mechs. I guess they don't count as mech units for the sake of bonus damage. Yeah. Good cleanup there by the Empire. And we... Whoa! Sith Masters on the field. Remember, of course, that Imperial unique tech, they do area effect damage. If the tech's been researched, of course. We're seeing a slow crawl. Jort resigns! They must be calling it. Either that or, like, somebody, you know, he got kicked on accident or something like that. Nice, GG. GG is called by all parties. I am not sure whether that was a resign or if that was, you know, like accidentally disconnecting. Because he still has 2,500 Nova. He's still got a lot of, you know, trade going, right? Yeah. So he's still got a lot of trade. So I don't think he was out of the game. But I do think that Jort was stuck on the defense for most of that. Kind of in this back and forth battle. And the real hope was Attack or Die would be able to push in and take out the Gungans. And I think when that swung on this side, and then the pressure just was going well for Gungan Empire on both sides, I think it makes sense to say they're losing, and I could imagine a world where Jort resigns that. So that was a really awesome battle. Guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, again, please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel. I really, really, really appreciate each and every one of you that does that. And let me know in the comments below that you enjoyed the video and you want to see more. For now, this is yours truly, the Iron Kaiser, signing off. Have a great day out there. See you around.